How can we use PROFILab as a decision-making tool? So in which case is it relevant to use PROFILab report? Well, we think it's interesting to look at it in all cases, but this profile really is a reflection of what's happening in the barn, and it does reflect herd management. So sometimes you don't have to be surprised of what you see on a profile when you think, you know, if you're feeding a not well fermented silage, well, you might expect the profile to not be optimized. So sometimes it's going to really reflect what's going on in the barn, but the profile can also suggest new possible solutions. So sometimes we think that, you know, we targeted an element that might be problematic on that farm, so it can confirm what our thoughts were, but it can also suggest new possible solutions that we didn't really think of from the start. So we're just going to look at a few herd cases and discuss how the PROFILab report was used in order to make suggestions and recommendations on these farms. So the first herd that we're looking into is a herd size of 180 cows lactating. They're Holstein cows with an annual production of 11,645 kilo, and they are milking 3 times a day in this herd. So looking at this profile here, so we're just going to walk through to the reading of the profile. So here the bright clear line is the provincial average. The darker line here is the producer's data. So here we see that he's always close to 4 kgs per hectoliter in terms of butter fat, and the protein is really, really close to the provincial average here. Looking at the fatty acid profile, so we start from the bottom and we walk our way up. So the de novo are slightly below average and really, really flirting with the average. So we're pretty much on average for this herd. Overall, on the other hand, the mixed and the preformed are below provincial average. Okay. So in this barn, things that we looked into when we see a profile like that, well, we did the Penn State, making sure that the PMR, the TMR was not something that the cows could be sorting, that there was effective fiber in there. Manure was looking good. Dry matter intake was validated. The transition of the cows going really good. The overall herd management is pretty strong, so we're really satisfied with that. However, there's a little bit of overcrowding going on in this barn. So as of June 3rd, the producers started up new fans in the milking cow barn, and we really see the impact on the profile and how it affected the cows. So here, June 3rd is when the addition of the farms, they really started up. We see that the de novo really flipped over that average, and they slightly increased here, and they had an impact on butter fat. So butter fat production increased as well. So you're probably all wondering what this drop here is at the end of June. Well, this is a change in silage. So, you know, it's something that's going to affect the cows for sure. So this is just an example of a management. So addition of farms in the barn, better ventilation, the impact that it can have on the profile like this. So it's something to always consider, the management of the barn. And this dairy producer, well, the biggest change that he noticed in his barn is that the herd behavior has completely changed. The cows are now uniformly distributed in the barn, and they are not crowding in a specific preferred spot anymore. So before, because there was not optimized ventilation, the cows were really crowding up altogether. So there were cows that were laying down and cows that were perched in behind those cows. With the new ventilation, the cows completely changed their behavior. They were really, really uniform in the barn. So it probably changed the feeding behavior on those cows as well, and, you know, circulation in the barns and stuff like that. So we can assume that the impacts are a lot related to behavior, and that's how it affected de novo. Second example that we're going to look into is a herd of 128 milking cows. Again, they're Holsteins. Annual production is 9,741 kilo, and this is a tie stall barn. So again, we'll walk through this profile. So the first here that we look are the components. So we see here that the provincial average is in this clear blue line, and the producer's average is below average. And here, at the end of June, beginning of July, butterfat really dropped closer to the 3.8 level. Protein slightly decreased as well, but really on the provincial average. And muns are pretty high in this scenario as well. Now again, we walk our way down and all the way up in the milk fatty acid profile. So here we see that the de novo are below the provincial average, the mixed as well, and the preformed as well. So all our fatty acid profiles are below average. So here When we look at the de novo that are below average, one thing interesting to do is always have a peek at the polyunsaturated fatty acid. So de novo that are below average and are polyunsaturated that are below average tells us that there are not many double bonds found in milk. So it seemed that biohydrogenation process is occurring pretty good in the rumen, but it seemed that maybe, you know, there's a lack of nutrients for their bugs to really optimize the production of de novo. So our things that we need to look after if our hypothesis is a lack of nutrients. We have a peek at MUN. So here MUN is above average. So it doesn't seem to be a lack of degradable protein in this case here. So again, we looked at a bunch of management things. So we validated the Penn State, making sure that there's plenty of effective fiber. Manure was looking good. Dry matter intake was validated with new updated feed ration analysis, and we made sure that the cows had access to water because this example here takes place in June and July, so in the middle of summer. So with the reading of the fatty acid profile, we came out to the conclusion that this lack of nutrients and the MUNs that were high, well, and we've verified the effective fiber, manure was good, and all of these management things. So what we decided to do in this herd is to add 0.5 kilo of ground corn mid-July. So we saw that there wasn't much of an impact. The butterfat was kind of like trending up a little bit here at the end. There wasn't much difference in the fatty acid profile. So we decided to go on and increase another time by 0.7 kilos of ground corn on August 5th. And then we really started to see better results in the rumen in terms of rumen health. So our de novo increased and reached the average, are mixed as well. So an interesting thing is to look which curve and which trend the mixed are following. It seems in this case that they are following de novo trend, which is pretty good. And see now the impact on overall butterfat on this farm. So butterfat reached back at provincial average. So this is one way that we can use the PROFILab report. And for sure, this occurs in July. Our first recommendation would probably have not been to increase ground corn in this farm, but when we tried it and we read the profile, we thought that it made sense to go that way, and the producer was willing to try it out. So this is how we stepped it up. So a 0.5 from the start and then a 0.7, and we really start seeing our improvement in this herd. So, you know, we can react pretty fast as well. You know, like this tool is updated on a regular basis, so it's easy for us to monitor the impacts of our changes. And in this case, it was really interesting to see the addition of ground corn in the summer, the benefit on the butterfat of milk. So this third example here is a herd size of a 50 cow milking cows. Again, they are Holsteins with an annual production of 9,570 kilo. And this herd is a milking robot herd. So we start here from the start with the producer's components. So butterfat was below average, close to like 4.1. Protein was pretty bang on the average as well. Now looking into the fatty acid profile. So we start by the de novo. De novo are flirting with the average and just above average at the beginning of March. Looking at mixed, they are pretty much on average and again increasing a little bit here beginning of March. But when we look at the preformed fatty acid, they are way below average. Like they are right on the average of the mix, which is quite low. So again, in this herd, we looked at feed bunk management, comfort, dry matter intake, and we looked at all of these things. It seems to be quite okay for management. But the one thing that we noticed, well, 2019 was not a pleasant year for silage quality. We had like a lot of variability in silage quality, and corn silage was dead at harvest, and grain corn was grade 4. So, you know, it wasn't the best grain corn, and it wasn't the best corn silage in this barn. So, what we decided to do once looking at the fatty acid profile, sorry. We decided to go ahead and add 200 grams of protected fat in this ration. So we used the Migalac type fat that we added up on March 5th. So 200 grams that was fed to the whole herd. And we can see here the impact. So milk increased by 0.4 kilo per cow, which is not a huge increase, but butterfat increased by 0.2. So really the average of butterfat increased and reached average, provincial average and just above. And we see here in the profile that the preformed fatty acid and the mixed fatty acid increased a little bit. And this change took place with no impact on de novo. De novo fats maintain really good level, being above average. We really, really played with the preformed fatty acid and a little bit in the mixed as well. And we really saw a positive outcome in butterfat in milk. So for sure, adding protected fat in the ration does have a cost. So we looked at the margin per cow per day. And in this herd, the margin found to be positive at 0.97 cents per cow per day. So for a 50 lactating cow herd, it's an impact on $48 and $50 per day. So it's really interesting when you look into a profile and you look into recommendation to do an economical point of view and just make sure that the decisions that were taking place to increase some of these curves are benefic in terms of profit on farm. So in this case, it had a herd impact quite positive. So we were really pleased to see the impact of Megalac in this farm. So PROFILab can help improving farm profitability, but we do have to monitor before and after changes just to make sure that we are moving in the right way. It's a flexible tools, and you know, cows are always right and they will always tell us the real story of what's going on. So sometimes when we look at the paper ration and we look at what truly happens in cows, we can have a few more elements to dig up and see if we can try to improve our things are going on in the farm. It's a quick and detailed validation. So sometimes when we only look at butterfat and protein, sometimes we don't have the whole story, but using PROFILab can really tell us a little more about how the cows are adapting to a change. So we can go a little more detail and react pretty fast to changes that are occurring in butterfat and in the fatty acid profile. So this is an example here of a herd where some things went wrong. So if we look here on July 5th, when you see a profile like this, you really, really have to be a little bit nervous about what's going on in the barn. So when we look at this, so de novo were pretty good level, mixed as well, and they really, really crashed at the same time. So this tells us that rumen function is not really working well and there's a crash in there. And when we look at preform, they really reached eye level really quickly. So this means that there is mobilization of fat. So something is going on in the barn and the cows are losing weight and we really have to look at what's going on. So looking here at butterfat was pretty constant. Like you would not have anticipated like a change going on in the cows looking only at butterfat and at protein. They reacted really fast. So the cows peaked and mobilized fat, but it went down pretty quick because they corrected the situation that was going on in the barn. But it reopened a little later here in August. They were feeding round bales that they had to feed. They had no other inventory. And when you don't react that fast and it takes place for a longer period, here again on butterfat, you don't see much of a change. The butterfat is pretty consistent in this barn, but look at how the protein dropped here. And remember that de novo synthesis will also affect milk protein. So it probably has an impact here. So when you can react really quick, sometimes looking butterfat and protein won't tell you the whole story. But if you see what's going on in your fatty acid profile and react, you might not see anything in the overall components. But if a change like this takes place for a longer time, well, at some points you're going to see some of the effects of what's going on in the poor rumen function. So this is a type of profile that you have to act pretty fast when you see this. So this really reflects fat mobilization in the herd level. So this producer, what he said when he saw this is that if he didn't have PROFILab, he would never have seen what was going on in the herd. So here, because he reacted really fast, things went good and the changes that were implemented, cows stabilized pretty good after it. But here, because it took place for a longer period, this here had reproduction consequences as well as drop of milk protein. So if you only look at overall butterfat and milk protein, it does not tell you the whole story. And that's why PROFILab is really interesting, because you can look a little more deeper and see what kind of fatty acid trend is impacting the results. So in conclusion, some important notes are do not overinterpret. Remember that we're playing with small numbers. So sometimes it looks like we're above or below, but we might just be on average, especially for polyunsaturated fatty acid. Keep in mind that we work with bulk tank milk. So again, like it's not because we make hypothesis on bulk tank milk that there are no cows that might have issues in the barn. And it's important to recognize critical profile, just like we looked. So this is a standard profile for fat mobilization going on in the herd. And one thing that I would say is try it. PROFILab is interesting. I work with it regularly on a daily basis, and we learn a lot from looking at these profiles and trying things on barns that we might not have tried from the start. So it's a new tool, but it will be beneficial for dairy producers for sure. And don't forget, so there's not only nutrition that plays an important part in the profile, in the fatty acid profile. There's going to be feed bin competition, ventilation, silage quality, water access, overcrowding. All of these management parameters are really critical, and they might have an impact on the PROFILab report. So keep in mind that there's nutrition, but there's everything else going on in barns that will be reflected in that profile.